These are more protest shots there, protests taking place not just outside the Pakistan High Commission here in Delhi. These are images here of Nawaz Sharif's effigy there being burnt in these shots here that are coming in from Nagpur. Remember, this is the sentiment that is echoing across the country. We've seen it in both houses of parliament. All opposition parties and the government stand united. An assurance, of course, that came in from the Home Minister Rajnath Singh in the Lok Sabha just about a few seconds ago, saying that how has Pakistan possibly established that Kulbhushan Jadhav was a spy when he held a valid Indian passport with an Indian visa all along, with 13 requests in the past year ever since he was taken in. Counselor access that has been denied to him, and the Indian government would do whatever possible for justice for Kulbhushan Jadhav.
फांसी की सजा सुनाई गई यह बहुत ही गलत है. भारत के प्रधानमंत्री आदरणीय श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी से मेरा यह आग्रह है कि कुलभूषण जाधव जी को जल्द से जल्द भारत वापस लाया जाए, और नहीं तो प्रधानमंत्री जी को सरेआम अभी तुरंत सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक करके पाकिस्तान को मुंह तोड़ जवाब देने का तुरंत वो कृपा करें. मेरा यही आग्रह है प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी से.
क्या लगता है कि सही समय आ गया एक्शन लेने का?
अब सही समय आ गया. जिस तरीके से भारत के ऊपर लगातार हमला कर रहा है, आज भारत के सैनिक को फांसी की सजा दिलाई गई. फांसी नहीं है, हत्या है. हर एक नौजवान व्यक्ति, भारत का हर एक सैनिक मुंह तोड़ जवाब देने के लिए पाकिस्तान को अब तैयार हो गया है. भारत माता की वंदे, वंदे भारत माता की, भारत माता की. कृष्णा कुमार सिंह कल्लू, अध्यक्ष पटना महानगर लोजपा.
Let's get in further inputs here. We have with us our senior editor, Madhav, with further details. Madhav, we've seen how this has played out in both houses of parliament. Each of the opposition parties unanimously standing together in asking for the government to push further. An assurance, of course, that came in from the Home Minister as well. What's next as far as the government of India goes, and the options that we possibly have to take this further?
Well, a number of options that the government has, of course. So we do know that this can be raised at international fora, where clearly Pakistan is in violation of the Geneva Convention and several such other conventions as far as the human rights of this particular individual are concerned. How can you have a case where, you know, you are tried not just in a military court, you know, instead of a civil in court, as well as the fact that, you know, the person who is arguing this for this particular individual, for Kulbhushan Jadhav, is actually a military officer. So how can a person who is an interested party in his own case be a judge in this matter, and how can the person who's given to defend him also be a person who's a part of the military establishment itself? So number of such violations that have taken place as far as the case of Kulbhushan Jadhav is concerned. Now what the government needs to perhaps do at that level, now that they have received the kind of political support that they wanted and they needed, clearly strengthen the government's hands. If anything, there has been more pressure on the government to act swiftly in this particular manner, and clearly, of course, that's what the government would have to perhaps take into consideration before deciding what future course of action to take. Of course, strong words coming in there from the Home Minister, as well as number of leaders cutting across party lines. We do expect Sushma Swaraj, also Minister of External Affairs, to make a statement in the Rajya Sabha as well on the same issue. Mm-hmm. And it's perhaps there that we'll get a clearer indication of what steps the government is planning on, where it is headed to, what is the strategy and the thinking as far as the government of India is concerned and the MEA is concerned at this point in time. Already a very strongly worded statement saying that if they go ahead with this particular death sentence to Kulbhushan Jadhav, it would be tantamount to premeditated murder. Now, an extremely strong language that has been used, clearly, of course, sending out a message yesterday itself. Will India take further steps today? That's what needs to be seen.
That's right. What could be the other possible steps that India would be taking, apart from the strong statement that has already come in from the MEA? Please stay on with us, Madhav, in further breaking inputs here, as we're looking at multiple protests that have taken place that are through the day slated to take place, some images of which we're playing out already.
अफसोस की बात यह है कि हमारी गवर्नमेंट इस पर कोई कदम नहीं उठा रही. हमें चाहिए कि हम अपने भाई का साथ दें. आतंकवादी वहां खुले हम घूमते हैं. बिल्कुल, हम यहाँ पे प्रोटेस्ट करने आप भाई के लिए.
पाकिस्तान से कभी रिश्ते नाते हमें तोड़ देने चाहिए. अगर उन्होंने हमारी बात नहीं मानी, बेकसूर, और जो हमारे सरकार है,
हमारे कुलभूषण भाई वहां गिरफ्तार है, हम उसके लिए आए हैं. हमें ये मैटर नहीं करता हमारी फैमिली से नहीं है. हम ये मैटर करता हूँ भारतीय है, और भारतीय होने के नाते हम उसके साथ खड़े हैं. अफसोस की बात है कि हमारी
मुर्दाबाद, पाकिस्तान मुर्दाबाद. आदमी है।
हेलो,
well, those were some reactions that we're getting you from the ongoing protest that is taking place outside the Pakistan High Commission office here in New Delhi, demanding the immediate release of Kulbushan Jadhav. Madhav, we've seen multiple political statements that have been made on this, an assurance that is coming from the Home Minister, a very strongly worded statement that came in from the MEA yesterday, calling it premeditated murder there. What are we expecting in the statement? Would this be a follow-up statement that would be made in the Rajya Sabha?
Well, already that the Home Minister Rajnath Singh has made a statement in the Lok Sabha. Clearly, of course, the statement that would be delivered by Sushma Swaraj, who's the External Affairs Minister in the Rajya Sabha, would be, in fact, on similar lines. The Home Minister's statement, of course, in the Lok Sabha, the lower house. So clearly, it would be by and large on the similar lines. But it is, of course, another minister, Sushma Swaraj, a person in charge of the Ministry of External Affairs, who would be speaking. So would there be any further statement that would be made by the government, and would we get any kind of hint as to what the future strategy would be as far as the government of India is concerned? There are many options, of course, apart from, of course, the kind of huge pressure that has been built up on Pakistan by the government of India. The matter, of course, can be raised at various international fora, as I was telling you, given that it's complete violation of various conventions, including the Geneva Convention, which all parties, all countries are subject to. Clearly, of course, complete violation of any kind of rights, of every kind of right that Kulbushan Jadhav has. And as India has been saying, it is completely fabricated and fictitious charges that Pakistan has leveled upon this particular individual, Kulbushan Jadhav, and has termed him as a spy. Now, clearly, of course, it remains to be seen what sort of action India will take further. It has already said that all those prisoners who were to be released, the 12 Pakistani prisoners who were to be released, that would be stayed, as well as pressure that has been built up on Pakistan in the form of very strong statements that have been coming in. So one needs to see what further course of action India would take vis-a-vis this situation. And certainly the only heartening thing perhaps to the government of India would be that, politically speaking, it does seem that by and large there has been a lot of support from various political parties. If anything, there has been a lot of pressure for the government to act fast and to take action.
Stay on with us. We're getting in breaking inputs, a reaction that's coming in from former Attorney General Mr. Soli Surabji, a senior legal voice. Let's take a listen in.
Under the cover of secrecy. And this is a good expression, secrecy is the battle of fraud.
So if this sentence is against an Indian citizen awarded without observing basic norms of law and justice, I mean, what's your take on this?
The question is, of course there are supposed to basic principles of natural justice. I don't think he was even given legal assistance.
No, not at all.
Deprived of legal aid and illegal assistance. As I said, it's a very regrettable move of Pakistan.
So now, the relation between both the countries, India and Pakistan. India was about to release some prisoners on today only, on Wednesday actually, but they have stopped this thing. So do you think that this case...
I don't think we should have a tit-for-tat attitude. India must observe proper principles of fair trial. I mean, which means keen keep.
We're going to be getting you.
What should be the way forward for India?
It's not a sentence, it's plain simple murder. Murder because the, a sentence is given after a trial. There was no trial. The world didn't see any trial. He was not granted any counsel. He didn't have any lawyer to defend him. There was no evidence. Their NSA himself confessed that there was no evidence against Kulbushan Jadhav. He was not even arrested in Pakistan. The fact is that he was kidnapped from Iran. And an innocent Indian citizen you treat like that, you just catch an innocent Indian citizen and you want to murder him. My only statement is this, that two can play it again. And international relations are based on reciprocity. We will deal with you as you deal with us. That is the basic fundamental rule of international relations. Therefore, if you hang one Indian, an innocent Indian, mind you, we can hang 10 Pakistanis who are not innocent.
And can only be ascertained if we have consular access to him. Accordingly, from the time his abduction was known, our High Commission in Islamabad has continuously pressed Pakistani authorities for such access. Although this is provided for by international law and is deemed a norm in international relations, the government of Pakistan did not permit it. That itself should tell us much about the strength of the case against Jadhav. Honorable members would also recall that a senior Pakistani leader has himself expressed doubts about the adequacy of evidence in this case. Honorable Deputy Chairman, sir, earlier this year, the Pakistan government sought our assistance to obtain evidence and other materials for the investigation process. In doing so, they leveled ridiculous charges against senior Indian officials who had no connection to this issue. Thereafter, they linked providing consular access to our acceptance of their position. Nevertheless, in the hope that some forward movement could be made, our response was constructive. We pointed out that consular access to Shri Jadhav would be an essential prerequisite in order to verify the facts and understand the circumstances of his presence in Pakistan. Given this exchange, it is extraordinary that yesterday a decision is suddenly announced awarding a death sentence in this case, when previous exchanges with India itself underlines the insufficiency of evidence. To make matters even more absurd, 3 hours after the death sentence was announced, the Indian High Commission received an official communication from the Foreign Ministry of Pakistan reiterating the Pakistani proposal for conditional consular access. That tells us a lot about the farcical nature of the alleged proceedings, which have led to an indefensible verdict against an innocent kidnapped Indian. Our position on this matter is very clear. There is no evidence of wrongdoing by Shri Jadhav. If anything, he is the victim of plan that seeks to cast aspersions on India to deflect international attention from Pakistan's well-known record of sponsoring and supporting terrorism. Under these circumstances, we have no choice but to regard this sentence, if carried out, as an act of premeditated murder. Deputy Chairman, sir, yesterday, Foreign Secretary conveyed our position to the High Commission of Pakistan. Let me state clearly that the government and people of India would view very seriously the possibility that an innocent Indian citizen is facing death sentence in Pakistan without due process and in violation of basic norms of law, justice and international relations. I would caution the Pakistan government to consider the consequences for our bilateral relationship if they proceed on this matter. Mr. Chairman, sir, I would also like to tell the House that I have been in touch with the parents of Shri Jadhav and we are extending our fullest support to them in this difficult situation. A strong sense of solidarity expressed by the House will give them more courage and strength.
The House is entirely one with the government on whatever steps you take in this. Morning, the office. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, please, LOP. LOP. Yeah, LOP.
Sir, sir, second mein puchna chahunga. I'm sorry, main late hua, but yeah. Aaj subah uthane wala tha, lekin hamare sabhi saathiyon ne uthaya is mudde ko. सर ये पूरे देश है, सरकार और विपक्ष का नहीं है, पूरे भारत का मसला है कि कुलभूषण जाधव जी को जिस तरह से एक सोची समझी स्कीम के तहत इसमें फंसाया गया है हिंदुस्तान को नीचे दिखाने के लिए और पूरी दुनिया में हमारी छवि को खराब करने के लिए. जो काम पाकिस्तान खुद करता है हमारे देश में वही इल्जाम हमारे पर लगाने का प्रयास कर रहे. अब जो वहां की फौज ने किया वो तो किया है, लेकिन इसके बाद दो और मरहले हैं. एक तो सुप्रीम कोर्ट और फिर उसके बाद राष्ट्रपति के पास जाएगा केस, लेकिन सुप्रीम कोर्ट सबसे ज्यादा जरूरी है. तो क्या हमारी सरकार उसमें पूरी मदद करे कि ऐसे वकील उसके पास हों जो सुप्रीम कोर्ट में उसकी, वहां की सुप्रीम कोर्ट में उसकी पूरी मदद करें, अदालत में ही हम जीत जाएं. किस इस तो मैं अपील करूंगा अपोजिशन की तरफ से, अपनी पार्टी की तरफ से, कि हमारे वकील इतने मजबूत होने चाहिए कि उनका पानी का पानी और दूध का दूध साफ.
उपसभापति जी, मैं बहुत शुक्रगुजार हूँ नेता प्रतिपक्ष भाईजान गुलाम नबी आजाद की, जिन्होंने ये कहा कि ये विषय पक्ष और विपक्ष का नहीं है, सरकार और विरोध पक्ष का नहीं है, बल्कि पूरे हिंदुस्तान का है, पूरे भारत का है। जहां तक उन्होंने हमसे पूछा है मदद करने की बात, ये तो बहुत छोटी बात आपने कही। सुप्रीम कोर्ट के लिए तो बड़े से बड़ा वकील, लेकिन केवल सुप्रीम कोर्ट से नहीं, इस पूरे केस में इसको बचाने के लिए जो भी करना पड़ेगा आउट ऑफ द वे जाकर हम लोग करेंगे। और मैं आपको ये बता दूं, जिस दिन से ये घटना घटी है तब से लेकर लगातार मैं उनके लोगों के संपर्क में हूँ, उनके माता पिता के संपर्क में हूँ, 3 बार उन्हें यहाँ मिल चुकी हूँ, कम से कम 6 बार उनसे फोन पे बात कर चुकी हूँ। और अभी इस घटना से पहले कोई संयोग था, पिछले मंगलवार भी, सोमवार और मंगलवार दोनों दिन मैं उनसे यहाँ मिली। इसलिए हम लोग बिल्कुल संपर्क में हैं। ये विषय पूरे, अब वो केवल अपने माता पिता का बेटा नहीं है, वो पूरे हिंदुस्तान का बेटा है। और हिंदुस्तान के इस बेटे को बचाने के लिए सुप्रीम कोर्ट की अपील या अच्छा वकील खड़ा करना तो बहुत छोटी बात है भाईजान, हम लोग प्रेसिडेंट तक भी जो बात करनी वो भी करेंगे और किसी ना किसी तरह से इस जादव को बचाने का काम।
धन्यवाद मंत्री साहब। यस, नाउ आई थिंक इट इज क्लियर, मिनिस्टर हैज सेड इट वेरी क्लियर, एंड द एंटायर हाउस इज विद यू इन ऑल दिस एक्शन यू आर टेकिंग, नो डिफरेंस। नाउ श्री टी सुब्रम रेड्डी।
सर, ड्रग मीन्स इन इंडिया वेरी सीरियस मैटर, इज किलिंग यंगर जनरेशन by ruining their bright future and career prospects. This is not only in Punjab, Northeast, but even in Delhi is also high on abuse of drugs by youth. The year 2016 saw the national capital emerging as Adata, Delhi, with the highest drugs all in India. So information collected from the investigation agencies at the center and the state level on drugs banned under the National Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Act showed that Delhi had the highest seizure of chemical-based intoxicants such as mind drugs, syrup and tablets. Sir, very serious matter. Overall, there has been a 5-fold increase in the confiscation of drugs in India since 2012, with the highest in the decade being in the year 2016. Last year, the agencies have confiscated 5 lakh kg of drugs and 8 lakhs banned tablets, estimated to be more than 50,000 crores in the international market. The World Drug Report identified India as the prime market for illicit opiates originating from Southeast and Southwest Asia because of its young...
Okay, that statement of course being made by our External Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj, equally strongly worded, the sense of which of course we'd gotten yesterday as well, once again reiterating that it is premeditated murder if Pakistan goes ahead with that execution. In multiple more reactions here that are coming in, this is a case, remember, where all opposition parties are standing united with the government in condemning this act by Pakistan.
Aap hamesha jaakar बगैर इनविटेशन से पाकिस्तान के प्राइम मिनिस्टर के बच्ची के शादी में जाते हो, क्या इसके बारे में आप बातचीत नहीं कर सकते थे? क्या डायरेक्टली मिल नहीं सकते थे? क्या टेलीफोन पे आप बात नहीं कर सकते थे? और क्या आपके एक्सटर्नल मिनिस्टर सभी लोग मिलकर इसको बचाने की कोशिश करना चाहिए? और इनको अगर नहीं बचाएंगे, मैं ये समझूंगा ये सरकार की कमजोरी होगी और भारत की कमजोरी होगी।
आप बड़ी पार्टीजन होकर के देखिए, वो जादव के साथ हम सब है, वो जादव के साथ हम सब है, पूरा हाउस है जादव के साथ।
चूंकि प्रधानमंत्री के नेतृत्व में देश में एक ऐसी मजबूत सरकार है जो पूरी दुनिया में एक ऐसा सिचुएशन पैदा कर रहा है कि पाकिस्तान को एक टेररिस्ट राष्ट्र घोषित करने के लिए पूरी दुनिया आज इकट्ठा है, इसलिए उसने कुलभूषण जाधव को एक गलत तरीके से बिना न्यायपालिका का सहारा लिए हुए, भारत सरकार को बिना कॉन्फिडेंस में लिए हुए, हमारे आदमियों को भारत सरकार ने जो प्रयास किया कि हमने 13 बार कोशिश की कि हमारे लोग कुलभूषण जाधव के साथ मिले। आज मेरा भारत सरकार से आग्रह है कि जिस तरह से हमारे नागरिक को उसने प्रताड़ित करने का प्रयास किया, उसको फांसी की सजा दी है, वो भारत सरकार एक्शन ले, पाकिस्तान को टेररिस्ट राष्ट्र घोषित करे और पूरी पार्लियामेंट एक सोच के साथ एक रिजोल्यूशन पास करे कि पाकिस्तान हमारे नागरिक को बाइज्जत बरी करे।
बगैर किसी प्रूफ के उन्होंने फैसला दिया है। यकीनन इस शख्स को, हमारे हिंदुस्तान के शहरी को, एक धोखा देकर ईरान से उसको पकड़कर लाए और सारी दुनिया के सामने इस तरह का एक नाटक कर रहे हैं। तो मैं सरकार से इस बात का मुतालबा करता हूं कि आपके पास बहुत बड़ी ताकत है, आपके पास इन्फ्लुएंस है, आप उसका इस्तेमाल क्यों नहीं कर रहे? और मैं यहां पर सियासत नहीं कर रहा हूं, आपको तो मालूम होना चाहिए था कि इस तरह का फैसला आने वाला है। तो इसलिए बेहद जरूरी है कि क्या ये सरकार पूरी कोशिश करेगी नहीं करेगी इस हमारे हिंदुस्तानी शहरी को बचाने के लिए, क्योंकि ये एक बाइज्जत शहरी है और इसकी जान बचाना हम तमाम की जिम्मेदारी है।
इट इज टेकिंग विंडिक्टिव एक्शन अगेंस्ट इंडियंस। द इंडियन गवर्नमेंट हैज हेल्ड बैक द रिलीज ऑफ सम पाकिस्तानी प्रिजनर्स ऑन दिस ग्राउंड। द गवर्नमेंट मस्ट रियलाइज दैट द होल कंट्री इज बिहाइंड इट।
कुलभूषण जाधव के पास यदि वैलिड इंडियन पासपोर्ट मिला है तो वह स्पाई कैसे हो सकता है, यह बात समझ में नहीं आती है। भारत पाकिस्तान द्वारा बगैर काउंसलर एक्सेस के इस सेंटेंस को मैं स्ट्रांगली कहना चाहता हूं कि यह जो फांसी की सजा जो सुनाई गई है, अध्यक्ष महोदया, भारत सरकार उसे स्ट्रांगली कंडेम करती है। और मैं यह भी सदन को आश्वस्त करना चाहता हूं, जो लॉ एंड जस्टिस के बेसिक नॉर्म्स होते हैं उसको बिना ध्यान में रखे यह फांसी की सजा उन्हें सुना दी गई है कुलभूषण जाधव को। और सदन को मैं आश्वस्त करना चाहता हूं, चाहे इसके लिए जो भी करना पड़े भारत सरकार वह करेगी और कुलभूषण जाधव के साथ न्याय होगा।
Let me bring in our colleague Madhav Das, joining us live with further details on what the situation is looking like right now. Madhav, we're looking at all political parties coming in together, as you were discussing this morning, that why shouldn't they come in together and condemn what Pakistan has really done. But not to miss, of course, important comments that are coming in from Union Home Minister Rajnath Singh as well as Foreign Affairs Minister Sushma Swaraj in the Rajya Sabha this morning.
Well, yes, in fact, a couple of important points, as you rightly put it. In fact, the urgency that is shown by members of parliament, particularly in the case, you know, recently of Ravindra Gaikwad, if they would show similar urgency in terms of getting Kulbhushan Yadav back, then that perhaps would be in order. But of course, the government would be heartened by the kind of responses that they've received from various political parties. If anything, they've been urging the government or putting pressure on them to ensure that Kulbhushan Yadav is returned at the very earliest. And that's really been the focus as far as all political parties, one can say, who have spoken on this issue in both the Lok Sabha as well as the Rajya Sabha. While in the Lok Sabha, Home Minister Rajnath Singh made a very pertinent point, saying that if he has been caught with a passport, how then is he being termed as a spy? That's of course something that no one has been able to explain, not Pakistan, not any of their representatives, and of course also completely refusing to give consular access to him, all of which has raised many questions. In fact, the conduct of the Pakistani government, even in terms of the trial itself, the fact that it's been a trial in a military court, whereas, in fact, clearly he's nowhere, in fact, entitled to that. He should be entitled to a civilian trial. Also, the fact that he has not been given a civilian lawyer. It was a military lawyer. You know, on multiple counts, all principles of natural justice that have been violated. And therefore, the Indian government quite clearly, you know, in the right, saying that it is premeditated murder that if Pakistan goes ahead and carries out this death sentence. But significantly, the speech made by Sushma Swaraj, External Affairs Minister, was also extremely important, because Sushma Swaraj focused on the entire aspect of a diplomacy, saying that Pakistan should look at the consequences that any such action could have on the bilateral relations between India and Pakistan. And that's where a very clear message has been sent out to Pakistan, you know, as far as relations between the two countries, how Absolutely. They could perhaps, you know, once again hit a low spot if Pakistan goes ahead with this. We have seen in the past how issues such as Sarabjit, etc., have also, you know, impacted on ties between the two countries. Clearly, Sushma Swaraj has sent out a very strong signal
and
to Pakistan from the floor of the House of the Rajya Sabha.
And she's in fact reiterated that very statement that came in from the MEA while she was speaking at the Rajya Sabha today, just a short while back. Yes, Madhav, stay on with us. Replaying that remark coming in from our External Affairs Minister while making that statement in the Rajya Sabha.
About the strength of the case against Shijad. Honorable members would also recall that our senior Pakistani leader has himself expressed doubts about the adequacy of evidence in this case. Honorable Deputy Chairman, sir, earlier this year, the Pakistan government sought our assistance to obtain evidence and other materials for the investigation process. In doing so, they leveled ridiculous charges against senior Indian officials who had no connection to this issue. Thereafter, They linked providing consular access to our acceptance of their position. Nevertheless, in the hope that some forward movement could be made, our response was constructive. We pointed out that consular access to Shri Jadhav would be an essential prerequisite in order to verify the facts and understand the circumstances of his presence in Pakistan. Given this exchange, it is extraordinary that yesterday a decision is suddenly announced awarding a death sentence in this case, when previous exchanges with India itself underlines the insufficiency of evidence. To make matters even more absurd, 3 hours after the death sentence was announced, the Indian High Commission received an official communication from the Foreign Minister of Pakistan reiterating the Pakistani proposal for conditional consular access. That tells us a lot about the farcical nature of the alleged proceedings, which have led to an indefensible verdict against an innocent kidnapped Indian. Our position on this matter is very clear. There is no evidence of wrongdoing by Shri Jadhav. If anything, he is the victim of a plan that seeks to cast aspersions on India to deflect international attention from Pakistan's well-known record of sponsoring and supporting terrorism. Under these circumstances, we have no choice but to regard the sentence, if carried out, as an act of premeditated murder. Deputy Chairman, sir, yesterday, Foreign Secretary conveyed our position to the High Commission of Pakistan. Let me state clearly that the government and people of India would view very seriously the possibility that an innocent Indian citizen is facing death sentence in Pakistan without due process and in violation of basic norms of law, justice and international relations. I would caution the Pakistan government to consider the consequences for our bilateral relationship if they proceed on this matter. Mr. Chairman, sir, I would also like to tell the House that I have been in touch with the parents of Shri Jadhav, and we are extending our fullest support to them in this difficult situation. Our strong sense of solidarity expressed by the House will give them more courage and strength.
The House is entirely one with the government on whatever steps you take in this. Morning, their office. Yes. Yeah. Yeah, please, LOP.
That, of course, being the defining statement that's coming from our External Affairs Minister, but it's not just the government. We've seen in both houses on what has been echoed unanimously, both in the Lok Sabha as well as the Rajya Sabha, in all the political parties, opposition parties coming together unanimously, of course, expressing that anger and slamming Pakistan. Madhav, what's the indication here as far as the government of India goes, having made their stand clear, of course, having also invoked the Geneva Convention and how there's been a human rights violation as per international laws as well. But what's next? The options here that India would have.
Well, one very clear aspect is that, that is an option that India will have to exercise, whether it chooses to take this issue up at various other international fora as well. And I do suspect that they would, given the kind of nature of the very serious action that Pakistan has taken, which is in a violation of, on multiple counts, really, the rights of any individual who's captured by either country. Now, he is not a terrorist. He is someone who has, in fact, been associated with the armed forces in the past, but as has been said, has been carrying out illegal business in Iran, in Jawar, and it's from the Iran-Pakistan border that he has been nabbed. And if, number of points that have been raised by Home Minister Rajnath Singh, for instance, saying that if he is a valid holder of a passport, on what account can he be then counted as a spy? Also, why consular access was not provided by Pakistan to this individual? So clearly, of course, on multiple counts, apart from, of course, the violations that have taken place through the process of the military trial itself, have raised a number of serious questions and a lot of concern here in India. All political parties speaking out in one voice, unitedly, asking the Indian government to take whatever action is required, both houses of parliament, the Lok Sabha as well as the Rajya Sabha, authorizing the government to take all possible measures that would be required to get back Kulbhushan Yadav to India. Sushma Swaraj coming out and also warning Pakistan very clearly of the kind of impact that all of this could have on the bilateral relations between the two countries. And that's very, very significant, because ultimately this is the only kind of language that would in fact be understood by Pakistan, because internationally, Pakistan already facing the specter of complete isolation, particularly in the wake of action that have been taken by various countries, particularly the United States, on various other aspects, in fact being forced to take action on a terrorist within its own soil as well. So clearly, of course, with this sort of action building up, the pressure being built up by India, you know, various politicians and political voices also suggested that international influence that India has and enjoys, that should be invoked to try and ensure that Kulbhushan Yadav is released at the very earliest. So, you know, top ministers of the government of India vis-a-vis what Pakistan should be doing in this particular case.
All right, so these are the options in front of India. Of course, like you're pointing out, strong messages being sent out there by the ministers and the parliament as well as all parliamentarians, Madhav. But if we were to speak of the options that Kulbhushan Yadav himself has in Pakistan in dealing with this situation as of now, what are the chances he has? Do they look bleak at this given point of time? The fact that this is a military court that has pronounced him guilty and sentenced him to a death penalty. Does he have the options of going to the civil establishment as well, or perhaps the Supreme Court, the President of Pakistan? Talk us through those options as well.
Well, yes, and interestingly, you know, these questions were raised by the opposition parties when this matter was discussed in the Rajya Sabha. In fact, the leader of opposition in the Rajya Sabha, Ghulam Nabi Azad, raised this very issue. Now, we do know how he has multiple options of appeal. There is, of course, the appeal before the Supreme Court. There is also the appeal, you know, before the Army Chief, given that this is a military court. And also, a last and final, of course, just as in India, he can also appeal to the President of Pakistan. So, the civil government, in that sense, would perhaps finally, eventually have a say as to what actually happens to Kulbhushan Yadav. So that is, of course, one possibility. But as was being pointed out by opposition parties, you know, in their Supreme Court, do we have adequate legal, you know, representatives? Have provisions being made? And, you know, will there be, you know, a strong case that will be made out to, you know, punch holes in whatever has taken place as far as the military court and its verdict is concerned? That's the concern that was expressed by the opposition. Sushma Swaraj, of course, saying that not just the Supreme Court, she's in regular touch with the family, but it's not just the Supreme Court. They will go all out and take all possible measures to ensure that Kulbhushan Yadav is returned to India at the very earliest. All measures that can be taken by
that's
the government
even
of India
knocking at the president's door is what she stated.
And ensure
there
that Kulbhushan Yadav
stay on
is
with us, Madhav. We're also being joined by our colleague, our assistant editor Ashish Singh, with further inputs here on this as well. Ashish, to what extent can India look at the unfortunate tragic case of Sarabjit to learn on how to deal with Pakistan this time, the possibility of this death penalty being commuted to a lifer as well, with a release following that?
Sir, I was speaking to a couple of top officials from the NSA's office and from the Ministry of Defense. What they have been telling me is that it has become an extremely complex case. It's not just a diplomatic case. It's not just the case of Kulbhushan Yadav. There's much more than meets the eye. Now, when I asked the subsequent question of what is the options or what are the possibilities that the Indian government is looking forward as far as the Kulbhushan Yadav's case is concerned, what they told me is that there's some kind of outside pressure working on Pakistan. Certainly, the way Pakistan was going on this particular case of Kulbhushan Yadav, the way Sartaj Aziz just a few weeks ago made statement that there was no major evidence against Kulbhushan Yadav except the statement. So what has gone wrong suddenly that has pressurized Pakistan to work in a hasty manner, and that is something what is the Indian government is looking at. Also, as I mentioned that when the officials of the Indian government mentioned that it's an extremely complex case, what they basically explained to me is it has military touch, it has judicial touch, it has a touch of some outside pressure working on Pakistan, whether it's a China pressure or something else. That is something the Indian government is currently exploring.
Right.
They're trying to find out at the ground level what went wrong, and that is exactly why
what
Indian
perhaps
government
suddenly
is,
accelerated the case
and
the final verdict on this. That's right.
Right. Request you to stay with us, please, Ashish, as well as Madhav. We'll come back to you for more. We have more reactions that are lined up. We'll take a listen in.
I would like to inform the House that Shri Jadhav was doing business in Iran and was kidnapped and taken to Pakistan. The exact circumstances are unclear and can only be ascertained if we have consular access to him. Accordingly, from the time his abduction was known, our High Commission in Islamabad has continuously pressed Pakistani authorities for such access. Although this is provided for by international law and is deemed a norm in international relations, the government of Pakistan did not permit it. That itself should tell us much about the strength of the case against Shijada. Honorable members would also recall that that our senior Pakistani leader has himself expressed doubts about the adequacy of evidence in this case. Honorable Deputy Chairman, sir, earlier this year, the Pakistan government sought our assistance to obtain evidence and other materials for the investigation process. In doing so, they leveled ridiculous charges against senior Indian officials who had no connection to this issue. Thereafter, they linked providing consular access to our acceptance of their position. Nevertheless, in the hope that some forward movement could be made, our response was constructive. We pointed out that consular access to Shri Jadhav would be an essential prerequisite in order to verify the facts and understand the circumstances of his presence in Pakistan. Given this exchange, it is extraordinary that yesterday a decision is suddenly announced awarding a death sentence in this case, when previous exchanges with India itself underlines the insufficiency of evidence. To make matters even more absurd, 3 hours after the death sentence was announced, the Indian High Commission received an official communication from the Foreign Minister of Pakistan reiterating the Pakistani proposal for conditional consular access. That tells us a lot about the farcical nature of the alleged proceedings, which have led to an indefensible verdict against an innocent kidnapped Indian. Our position on this matter is very clear. There is no evidence of wrongdoing by Shri Jadhav. If anything, he is the victim of plan that seeks to cast aspersions on India to deflect international attention from Pakistan's well-known record of sponsoring and supporting terrorism. Under these circumstances, we have no choice but to regard this sentence, if carried out, as an act of premeditated murder. Deputy Chairman, sir, yesterday, Foreign Secretary conveyed our position to the High Commission of Pakistan. Let me state clearly that the government and people of India would view very seriously the possibility that an innocent Indian citizen is facing death sentence in Pakistan without due process and in violation of basic norms of law, justice and international relations. I would caution the Pakistan government to consider the consequences for our bilateral relationship if they proceed on this matter. Mr. Chairman, sir, I would also like to tell the House that I have been in touch with the parents of Shri Jadhav, and we are extending our fullest support to them in this difficult situation. Our strong sense of solidarity expressed by the House will give them more courage and strength.
The House is...
...jo wahan ki fauj ne kiya, wo to kiya hai. Lekin iske baad do aur marhale hai. Ek to Supreme Court, aur phir uske baad Rashtrapati ke paas jayega case. Lekin Supreme Court sabse zyada zaruri hai. To kya hamari sarkar उसमें पूरी मदद करे कि ऐसे वकील उसके पास हों जो सुप्रीम कोर्ट में उसकी वहां की सुप्रीम कोर्ट में उसकी पूरी मदद करें अदालत में ही हम जीत जाएं किस तो मैं अपील करूंगा अपोजिशन की तरफ से अपनी पार्टी की तरफ से कि हमारे वकील इतने मजबूत होने चाहिए कि उनका पानी का पानी और दूध का दूध साफ
Right, going back to our colleagues Ashish and Madhav bringing us further details. As we have heard, all politicians cutting across party lines, including the government, condemning what Pakistan has done, issuing very strong statements this afternoon on Pakistan's development over there. But Madhav, if we have history to go by, I might sound a little skeptical, but the issue of incident of Kirpal Singh, Saurabjit Singh, Chamil Singh, Kishore Bhagwan, in the last 5 to 6 years, we've seen what has happened with Indians in Pakistan. The chances that today... Kulbushan Jadhav really has, are they bleak or is there a way out? Madhav.
Absolutely. In fact, you've actually pointed out a very significant aspect that the absolutely insensitive manner in which Pakistan has responded to India's concerns in all of these cases of all of these prisoners is certainly something that would be causing a huge amount of worry here in the national capital, particularly in South Block, as far as the Ministry of External Affairs is concerned. Of course, what is heartening to note is that certainly all political parties of various hues have come out in support of the government and have said that whatever steps need to be taken, the government should, in in fact, go ahead strongly with it, pursue them to ensure that, in fact, Kulbhushan Yadav is returned. Not just steps here domestically, but also internationally, raising the issue at international fora, and also using India's influence globally to try and ensure that Kulbhushan Yadav is returned, that Pakistan is made to see what India's perspective is, and its concerns are all addressed. Those are perhaps some of the matters that have been raised. Also, of course, one will have to look at what happens to this case legally, given the fact that there are various appeals that are pending, that could in fact be made, and perhaps the sentence, particularly the death sentence that has been handed out by that military court, could be commuted, because that, of course, would be the first step in ensuring that at least the kind of threat that exists with the fact that a death sentence has been pronounced is not acted upon by the government. That, of course, would be very significant in warning Pakistan, that cautioning them that this could directly impact on the bilateral relations between the two countries.
Right.
One will have to wait and see if all of this has any impact at all on the Pakistan establishment.
Stay on with us. We're seeing how similar sentiments echoing on the street here as well. Multiple protests that we've seen through this afternoon, through the day as we speak. One that is taking place outside the Pakistan embassy here in New Delhi, in Nagpur as well. A set of protests that have been seen with sloganeering on there against Pakistan. These are images.
कुलभूषण के पक्ष में हम नारे लगा रहे हैं और भारत सरकार से खासकर सुषमा स्वराज जी से माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी से और राजनाथ सिंह से विनती करेंगे कि कुलभूषण को बाइज्जत बरी करें और देश के अंदर लाएं और देश के युवाओं का गौरव बढ़ाए.
Evident what the sentiment on ground here is, has been, but Ashish, to what extent could the answer lie in the speculation on what prompted Pakistan for this sudden verdict on a case that they'd been sitting on a case in which you had Sartaj Aziz speak in the House of their parliament there, saying that there is insufficient evidence so far to take it any further. What prompted, what perhaps were the outside forces, safe to say that, that prompted Pakistan to take this immediate decision on his case?
See, Sahar, that's exactly what the government is exploring currently. What is being shown for the public, be it the statements in Parliament by the Home Minister and the Minister of External Affairs, and the way a BJP spokesperson and the Congress party has been doing, is just for public viewing, for public to know that the government is standing behind Kulbhushan Jadhav. But there is much more than that happening behind the curtain. I am told that the Prime Minister is keeping a constant watch as far as the updates, the options, and getting the feedback from ground is concerned. The top officials from the NSA's office, IB, RAW, everyone is on the job to ensure that what kind of possibilities can be offered before the further action can be decided. So as I mentioned, what is being shown here in public is much less as compared to what's happening behind the curtain with the Prime Minister's office, the National Security Advisor, the Ministry of External Affairs, and also the Ministry of Defense officers, including Army, has been kept on board to ensure that every possibility is explored before India decides to go ahead. As I mentioned, it's an extremely complex case. It is not a mere fact of going through a judicial process in Pakistan. That is not something that the Indian government is ready to believe. They know that there are various factors outside Pakistan, factors, something which has been influenced by the Pakistani army, by the ISI. All these factors are being considered before India gets a full sense of minute details of what has gone wrong. It was not the exact course and pace with which the case was proceeding. It was certainly not, it didn't go down well with the Indian government. The way Kulbhushan Jadhav was kidnapped and then was, without telling the Indian High Commission Islamabad, was being tried. So all these minute factors are being considered, and I believe in next few days, the Indian government will have a much clearer and better picture to decide what kind of reaction should be done from India.
Okay, I request you, Ashish, as well as Madhav, to stay with us. We're coming back to both of you as we continue to track more details. Now we're looking at anger spilling out on the streets across the country.